We are on the west side for another edition of Sam Choi's in the Kitchen. World-renowned chef Sam Choi, his sous chef John Venerian. We're at the house of world-renowned athlete and former sumotori Konishiki, or Salivaa Tissanoi.
That's right. And you know what? He loves his Japanese food.
Yep.
You know, and the simple stuff, you know, not the real, you know, just simple.
Well, we decided we'd catch up with him and his wife, Chie, while they're home for just a short visit. Let's go see what they got in the
kitchen.
Let's go.
That sounds good. Let's go.
Uncle Sam, look at this house.
You first.
Beautiful, huh? Wow, man.
Hey, my main man.
Hey.
Salivaa.
Hey, thank you.
Thank you. Oh.
Hey.
Good to see you, sir.
Thank you for having us.
Hello, hello.
We just come to see you and film this moment.
We're going
to
dig through the fridge.
We never.
You have my whole fridge to go through, brother.
What's your favorite
thing? I like to cook noodles. I like to cook spaghetti. I like to cook curry, fried rice. Fried rice, I'm good at it. Because we always get rice.
Of course.
And rice, I always surprise her. How you did this? How you did that? I go in the icebox just like how you guys do. Whatever's in there, I figure it out.
Now we know what he likes. I want to see what he has in the fridge.
Yeah, we'll do that.
You're not here all that often.
No, that's like much of the stuff.
Oh, man.
Most of the stuff you see in my icebox is people bringing it over.
Okay.
We read it and go shop.
Well, John, I tell you what, it's very nice and neat.
There's no shortage on rice.
Well, you know what? The competition is on. One bag for me. That's it. The show will be the competition. One bag for me.
Whoa. See, we always get plenty of rice.
Fried rice challenge right now.
Okay, what do we have? We got to see what we have.
Oh, man, God. Got everything in here. Wow.
A lot of sandwich stuff because we like to.
Amazing.
Whatever. I love pickles and we got wasabi in there. We got all the ham stuff.
It looks like cut up turkey bacon.
Vegetarian stuff.
Oh, nice. You vegetarian though?
No.
Who, me? I only eat meat, vegetarian meat.
Okay. How often do you stay here throughout the year?
I come about 4 to 5 times a year.
Okay.
Majority for work. And then we're going back to Japan on a ship. Uncle, there are two types. That's Japanese mayonnaise. Get one with karashi. Kind of with
mustard
inside. The Japanese mustard, yeah.
Just the one. Mustard.
Yep.
This is the good stuff, though.
Some sausage.
Oh, there's sausage, too. I never know
you had sausage.
Kinokata.
Somebody bought it.
You got that cool cut in there.
Spinach and pesto sausage.
Man, I don't know. You got a lot of stuff in here. Who bought the poke?
Chie and us, we love poke.
Yeah?
Yes.
I have to make something poke for you guys.
Oh.
Crazy. Yes. Where's this from?
Tamura.
Tamura. Oh,
Tamura.
There you go. Yep.
Wow. Put these back, keep them cold. Now we know where it's at. Well, we got noodles there, but I want to check what kind of noodles they got there.
Yeah, we're going to check later on there.
All right. Time now for bok choy. Whatever's in this, we have to use in the meal that Uncle Sam makes. He doesn't know what's in it, but we're about to find out.
Okay. Uh-oh, we have this.
What is that? No Foods Chinese orange chicken sauce.
Wow.
And then we have the
dressing.
Ume.
Oh,
the ume shiso.
Ume in Japan, made in Japan. Wow, for real?
Yeah, very good.
And that is bok choy.
Is that all that?
Bok choy, that's all you have. Not bok choy, you have bok choy choy in there. Whoa!
Oh, wow, yeah, man, this is amazing. Oh, John, you just know how to pull them out, eh?
Well, I saw the rail, and I noticed that you could pull it out.
Some dry noodles here. I don't know, I kind of like this one, the flat noodle.
I can't read it, so
that's
I
mean, so
I
wouldn't even.
This is the good stuff?
This is so man. There's different noodles you guys gotta remember in Japan.
It's all about noodles.
And there's like udon noodles.
You have a lot of this one. What about this one?
That was all over you get from all the way down southern Japan, the Kyushu area.
Yeah.
And then we have taste all the way up to Sapporo, which is northern Japan. That's not only the rack, you gotta look in the second rack too. There's all kinds
second
of stuff.
Second rack.
This is amazing.
This is like a candy store. It's awesome.
Yep, I think we had enough.
Uncle Sam, what are we doing?
Well, I tell you what, we're gonna go through a little cooking class right now with Sally and the wife. We're gonna do some of their dishes that they do back home.
Yeah, I got some, I got all kind of men's, we call, you know, like ramen. This is called kishimen, it's famous in Nagoya. And then we have what Uncle Sam has, and it's called somen. It's what I think you guys find here in Hawaii, you guys are supposed to eat it cold. Mm. So we're gonna show you the correct way how to eat it, how to prepare it. And so if you can actually buy it and cook it yourself at home.
What is this? It looks like the bottom of a palm.
Well, it's actually green onion. In Japan, we use the shironegi, they call it. It's called white onions. So it's, we chop it up, and that's what we put in all most of our soups and stuff.
Really?
When in miso soup and stuff like that.
But the white part?
That's the white part we eat. We don't eat the green part.
Really?
Yes. But here, we eat the green part. It's the green onion. That's why we call it green onions.
I eat the whole thing, but that's but this is like another, so much bigger.
Because Japan, they have many different onions. They have banonegi, which is a very thin one, which they use different. They use it when they do like fugu. The balloon fish, as they use that for fugu and different real expensive good
delicate
fish.
Dishes.
Yeah, delicate dishes. They use what they call bando negi, which is thinner. So that's all green.
I kind of split it, so.
Why are you splitting it?
Well, you just want to, because you want to get into like bite sizes. I don't want to do it like where we got the whole thing all cut up, you know what I'm saying? We want to just go easy as we need. And then from here, just straight down, keep it tight. Right, Solly?
Yep.
Just
nice
like that. Hey, you see that right there, Johnny?
Yep, I see it. You're almost done with it, so maybe you should just finish it.
No, no, no.
Okay,
all
right.
How's our water? Our water's are boiling?
Okay, my turn. So we have the water going on. So we just, kishimen. Just show me there.
Thank you for doing this.
Thank you for coming.
How many onions do you want?
Yeah.
Get our busy lives going on.
Drop it in?
Yep.
Anyway?
Anyway.
Good?
Can you get an onion like this in Hawaii?
Yeah.
I think that's where they bought that one.
Really?
My wife bought them yesterday. I think that's the only thing she buy.
Down to us?
Down to earth.
Oh, down to earth. And now we know.
Don't take too long to cook, right, this one here?
Yeah, you just gotta watch them. Don't overcook it.
I think we're good already.
Yeah, I get him. I get him.
You like check on
him? Yeah, he's good. He's good. For me, it's heat. He's gonna just get better.
Okay.
So where do you go from there then? What are you gonna do?
You cool it down.
Yeah, cool it down. Okay.
Hot, 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 hot.
Sesame oil.
Abura.
In. John, I think we cook the fried rice in this pot here.
Okay.
No, I'm going to go right now.
Cuisine.
Oh, you put it on top now? No, no ice water for this.
No. This is going right into this, right?
So you, okay, so you boiled it, and now you're going to fry it.
Yeah.
Get all the water out?
Yeah.
No water. Shake it, water out. You like them now?
Yep.
How about some green onion?
Yeah, green onion too, I like it.
Big onions. 1, 2, 3, 4 cut.
Okay. Going?
Going.
Maybe more, isn't it?
Mm.
Okay, Solly, tell me what's going on back there.
I'm cooking the kishimen, some of the noodles that we boiled.
Yep.
These are the fatter noodles.
Okay.
So, and now we just added some of the meat that we use for sandwiches to it, that we never have enough bread to make sandwich.
You said Dad likes that, huh?
Yeah, Dad likes that.
Are you cooking up, are you doing that for him?
Yeah. So you got cut them.
Okay, so you got that going.
You can cut that one too.
Okay, for his.
Yeah. So we got a lot of things going on right now. We got the noodles in ice. We got the noodles in the hot pot. We got ham going in there.
So Solly, you eat a lot of noodles then. I'm just guessing.
I love noodles.
A Of all of Hong Kong's cultural treasures, one combines its Chinese tradition with a strong influence of the British, who ruled the region for more than a century. At the Campari factory, Golden Master Qian Baoxing teaches a class how to make milk tea.
There's three or more different kinds of tea blended together. Put into the bag, the water poured into the tea leaves around 3 to 5 minutes.
So right now the tea is steeping.
Yes.
Then the mixture is strained 4 times in what's called the silk stocking method, because the bag resembles a stocking. To that is added evaporated or condensed milk, introduced to Hong Kong by the British. The whole process takes up to 20 minutes. Hong Kong hosts a milk tea preparation competition every year, and Qian has won several times, earning him the title Golden Master. Milk tea houses suggest you drink just 1 cup a day because the potion contains as much caffeine as 9 cups of coffee. Whew. Now back to Sam in the kitchen.
No,
I'm good.
Oh man, look at that. So what he's done is he's got the noodles stir frying,
yep,
along with some green onions. And then
he just added the hot dog in it.
Hot dog, and then got ham and tofu sausage, turkey sausage.
It's like a Konishiki chaofan, you call it.
Ah!
Chaofan style.
Konishiki fun.
Big fun with konifan.
So we're doing cold noodles, we're doing hot noodles.
And fried rice.
And fried rice.
And a poke salad.
And a poke salad.
I think if I remember how you did it with it.
Okay, Sala, there you go.
Really quick. Oh, brother, this is a meal right here.
I'm a good learner. And we have the porgy. Be careful. That's not good. Sorry.
That's you.
Present porgy, not offended.
So I know, I'm sorry.
No, I'm not.
I got scolded already.
No. You can wipe from your wife.
Oh. I don't even go there. Would you bring up the poke?
Poke.
Fish sticky doing it.
Ah, what's it?
What's your shit?
Ach.
Come in.
Come in.
Let's try it a little bit.
No, for real, the thing is good.
Tamanegi, you didn't work.
Tamanegi, nice.
Poke.
Two.
Good.
So, what do you say, Dustin?
You guys thought I only sumo, eh?
No. You know why?
Uncle Sam knew me, so.
I know you, man. You can cook.
I know.
これ?
So.
Dechatta.
Huh?
Yasai dechatta.
Skoshi.
You did half?
Yeah, and then cut me some chiffonade of green onions. And that's gonna go right on top.
It is.
Soto kerum. あのさ、下のさら 出して、こう入れる。
Charlie, what you need?
I'm good.
Okay.
どれ?これ?
そうそう。
I use, please. Whew, I can taste it already.
How much you like?
That's it, right or wrong. And then the last thing I want to do, I'm going to make a combination. A combination of the yuzu,
the shiso,
and bun.
The sesame one?
Yes. Have to mix.
Sally, what is the sesame? The
goma.
Sesame.
Goma opera. They ready to shoot this?
Yeah.
Okay.
So this is what we call shimen. I made it into the konishiki fun. And we have lettuce. And so it looks healthy because it is healthy. This food is not in there, but Japanese style mini.
Oh, already in there. You put it in there already.
He's already in there.
Oh,
you can't see it. It melts in your mouth, not in your hand.
All right.
All right.
I just add a little bit of this.
The shiso.
The shiso, I'll always show you shiso.
Oh, make me even more shiso. Oriental.
Just a little, not too much.
You know, on half, you're doing half.
On half, and then all the way from
Chapang.
Chapang.
You don't want to mess that, you don't want to have spill any of that. That stuff is gold.
Yeah, just a little bit, not too much, you know, because you have the poke, you got nice taste, yeah.
Okay, while Uncle Sam's starting that,
yeah,
I want to talk about this.
Okay, that's called somen.
So you cook the somen like you would normal noodles, boiling
but always
water.
Always check them because you don't want to overcook. It takes about 45 seconds to a minute.
45 seconds.
So you after drop you it boil.
In. So you once boil the water's water. Boiling, you drop the noodles in, done in less than a minute. Then you immediately throw it into a bowl of ice water.
Yeah, you wash it down one time, then you throw it in.
Why did you do that?
Because now you can like...
It's completely separated.
Yeah, completely separated.
It's not stuck.
When you throw the thing, it'll stick to each other. Because it's rice, it sticks, right?
Okay. It doesn't lose any of the taste, though, that you wash
no,
off?
No, at all.
Okay. All right.
It's your sauce, isn't it? Going to make it, put in the magic, have okay. the magic.
Well, Sam, what do you got in there so far?
We got the big Japanese green onions, right?
Okay. Yeah.
That's locally grown. I got the sausage, right? The tofu sausage, turkey sausage.
Pesto spinach, yep.
Yeah, pesto spinach.
Okay, you have the Japan rice that Sally said is way better.
Yeah, the Japan rice. And then, of course, we just added some ham.
Okay.
And then we added some other green onions, local kind of green onions, and I added a little bit of aloe shoyu.
Okay.
And
now
much.
You're gonna add some nose Chinese orange chicken sauce.
Yes, right here, right in the middle. Okay, that's good. I think this is going to really
I
nice.
I thought Sally was going to make the fried rice.
No, well, we got so much things going on,
I
dude.
Know, we do. We have.
And you know, the thing about this cooking, it's speedy. You need speed.
Yeah.
We know you guys from Kamehameha making us slow down.
Wow. Ouch. I catch cracks from Kahuku.
Hey, country boys. You come up the hill, eh? No worries. We love you. We love you, John.
Johnny. Yeah, you know me, man. You know I love you, Johnny.
We love you, bro.
Can I get some black pepper or?
Right down the side, uncle.
Oh, okay. Oh, right here.
Yeah. We knew we'd use that all.
Yep. Gonna waste. Good. Here you go.
Thank you.
You're right. That is some good stuff. Okay. Coming in hot.
Yep, right in hot. John, you know what you're gonna do, eh? You're gonna pack them up in that bowl. You're gonna put your magic.
Okay. It looks like we're done.
Yeah.
So you know what time it is, huh?
Yeah, I'm hungry. I don't know about you, I'm hungry.
Time to grind.
Time to grind. Okay, honey, you try.
Okay, your turn.
Sam Choice, come on. Sam Choice.
Sam Choice.
Very good.
Okay, let's eat. Uncle Sam, let's recap.
Well, I made a poke salad that they had some nice fresh tamura's poke.
Okay.
Two types.
Yep.
And then I had a little somen noodles on the bottom and some nice mixed greens. And then I added the poke with two different dressings. One with the aloha shoyu ume and chiso dressing. And then this one here, the creamy goma, just a little bit. And then we made a fried rice because Sally, you say you do a lot of fried rice back home.
A lot of fried rice.
So I got a whole bunch of different flavors in there. We added what's in the
tofurkey, spinach, and pesto sausage.
Right. And some ham, little ham.
A little bit of ham.
And the Japanese green onions and the local green onions. But they're both grown here in Hawaii.
Okay, Sally, and you did something special right
for me. I did what Uncle Sam has in his salad, the somen.
Okay.
The somen, we're going to just, it's actually just boiled and then it's in cold water. Right? We're just going to show you afterwards, the two sauces that you can use to dip the right way to actually get it, because I see it in a lot of places that they do it wrong. I see it all mushed up and all sticky, which is wrong. I just wanted to educate our viewers about that. The other thing I made was the fried, I call it konifan. The ingredients are like we have the two different onions that Uncle Sam had. Because I had so much things to make sandwiches, I used the ham was in there. And they had salad vegetables that I had steered in there, so I mixed it in the vegetables. And then actually the we have mayonnaise at the bottom. That's what gives the kick, the low kick, the high kick, and a knockout punch. The mayonnaise makes it rock and roll. That's the goma.
The goma.
So you can actually use the somen.
How much do you put in there?
As much as you want.
Okay.
The somen. Then you just grab the somen.
Okay.
make the water drip.
We're getting a lesson here.
You gotta let it drip, Uncle.
Let the water drip.
Not too much,
yeah? Yeah, that's good. You just dip this way. Dip them.
That's good, huh?
Yeah, it's good. See, look how nice.
Oh, that much.
That's good.
Okay. Oh, you got slurping it and everything. That's the right way.
That's the slurpee. Japanese slurpee.
Okay.
That's amazing.
It's good, huh?
Yeah.
Oishi. Oishi.
Oishi, oishi.
Okay. Let the water drip and then.
So that's the right way.
Thank you so much for having us.
Thank you for having us, man. I'm glad you guys came over.
Thank you. This was a great meal, but just nice to catch up with you.
Yeah, it's good to be home and talk to my uncle over here.
Yeah,
we see a lot of each other in Japan, so more in Japan here, I think.
That's right.
But remember,
when Sam Choi is in the kitchen,
you can do the cooking.
Not the place I want to be right now, but of course. How did you and your wife, Chie, meet?
She was working at a place that does therapy. I was a patient.
And then you suckered her in with...
We love.
That's awesome.
And she saw my okole, man. You're a nice okole. Yeah, like, it's not only a man thing, you know.
Where did the show go?